Eileen Smith here, and I want to thank you if you're a subscriber, because we reached a milestone of 7,000 subscribers here on the channel. And if you're a patron, you know how special you are because you're getting early access to this video. And if any of you guys want to become a patron, go over to patreon.com/Eileen and check out the perks. I want to talk about EcammLive. EcammLive is my favorite live streaming platform. It is a Mac-based platform, and there's a few questions that come up every now and then. Like, for example, people ask me if I share my iPhone screen. And the best way to share the iPhone screen is using QuickTime, because you're on a Mac, and so you can use the QuickTime. It's absolutely free. So let me just show you a couple of tips about it before you get started. So you're going to, first, you have to plug your phone, your iPhone, into your computer via the USB to Lightning cable. That's a must. Next, you're going to open QuickTime, and let's see if I can get this image up. And it's really important, notice at the top left of the screen, that you are going to go to the file menu in QuickTime, and the first selection there is new movie recording. That's very important. You have to turn on the new movie recording option. So let's see if we can do a little screen share and show you a little bit more about what we need to do. I'm going to actually screen share the iPhone, and I might as well screen share it over on the Patreon page. So once you open up the new movie recording, now this is me screen sharing my iPhone with QuickTime. You'll see these controls down here at the bottom. Very important. So let me zoom in a little more on that, because if you don't do this part right, it's not going to work. You have to make sure that you choose the option to screen share from your iPhone, because you're pretending like you're making a movie, although you're not actually making the movie, you're just screen sharing it in your broadcast, okay? So go down to that menu that's right next to the red play button, okay? And you're going to make sure that the camera is set to your iPhone. And you also want to make sure that the audio is set to the iPhone. All right, and I like to use high quality. Let's make sure I can bring that in on screen here. Let me back out a little so you can see at the very bottom of that menu, it asks you if you want high quality or maximum. Why not go for the high quality, right? Okay, so that's very important. Then once you're ready to go ahead and screen share with the Ecamm Live, then you just go up to the screen sharing menu and choose the option to share your QuickTime. That will display whatever is on your phone. So let me just switch up and go to another application. For example, you may be showing someone how to do something on Instagram, which is something that I've done quite a bit. There's my little niece. Okay. So now, the next thing that is really important is we're talking about microphones, because this question came up in one of the user groups, and it has to do with making sure that you're on the right microphone in your live stream, no matter what, whether you're screen sharing or if you're just on cam, okay? So the one you want to check is in your preferences, in your Mac preferences. Let's bring that up. At the very top left of your screen when you're on the Mac is the little apple. Click on the apple and then open up System Preferences, okay? So I'm going to do that now. Let's move the QuickTime out of the way. And let's open up the System Preferences. and get a little screen sharing going there with the system preferences. Now I'm going to make sure that I'm only sharing that system preferences window. Okay, there you go. And we'll make it bigger. These are all the tips that you have to keep in mind. You can set these up ahead of time if you're savvy enough. Then you want to click on sound. Very important, guys. Click on the sound icon. And you notice here the input, because there's different tabs on the sound menu. Okay? And the input is the one that's important for us to make sure that we're being heard in our broadcast. So on the input, you're going to make sure that it's picking up from the microphone. You don't want it to pick up from the webcam, and you don't want it to pick up from the built-in microphone. You notice that there are sound indicators to let you know you're on the right mic. Notice if I turn it down, I get too quiet. Turn it back up. Sound is a lot better. They also give you on this page, even though we're on the input page, they put a little menu down at the bottom just to make sure that the output, that you know that your volume is turned up on your output, and you can show the volume in the menu bar. I highly recommend doing that. That's just a quick and easy way for you to turn your volume up on your computer when you're listening. So your output is what you're listening to. Your input controls your mic and the input that you are putting into the system. So once again, if you want to contact me, if you have any questions, you will go to eileen.link/contact. Now that's if you want to contact me via email. But I also have a SpeakPipe page, and you can contact me via voicemail at eileen.link/voicemail. Because I love, love, love answering your questions. Of course, patrons get special preference. So you go to patreon.com/Eileen. And I want you to have a wonderful day. And I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.